Hi there. This will be a very quick one. I already recorded it yesterday, but for some reason YouTube failed to upload second time today. So I'm gonna quickly go over it, what I did yesterday. It's mainly a hell of a work, to be honest, to get the wagon set up correctly. It's not 100%, but we are getting what we want slowly. First, like I say, the end result is all determined by the quality or the amount of animations you got. So I buy, I was hoping that this skeleton was easy to retarget to the horse I already had, but yeah, first of all it was not. So if you have the Kaskir character with the horse, you cannot use it with this horse anim set, but it comes with horses already. I will show it. This got all those animations, so I'm gonna very quickly, because I'm gonna 11 alt p, voila. So like here you see that is from yesterday, that is the one I put physics on, that is the one with bones in the background, but don't mind that one. That is testing purposes for the moment. This is a new horse. You will see soon why I say that when you have the animations, or you have like a saddle separated and then gear separated, you can do nicer workflows or effects, or how you want to call it. So you see that turning, I leave it visible for the moment. So what I did, the problem was in the last video, I say like I'm gonna give you the well. In the meantime I was then focusing also back to the wagon, and it was working. And the day after I load the project, I press play like now, and all of a sudden the trailer is really flying, crashing into the ground, flying, crashing into the ground. And I said, that was not yesterday. So again, break everything apart, not break everything, but disable all the physics and then start over again. Now, what we have now, so the trailer is, first of all, hold on, maybe I can quickly show you that first. I still got him here, eh? Yeah, I still got him here. So that is, if I'm not mistaken, 3000 mass I put on that one. The block on. Ah, shit, yeah, it's true. Come on, damn it. I put it down. Here, somewhere around here. Okay. Yeah. Excuse me for the background noises, because the kids are, and I got two boys, very active. You see, it's riding, and it's going good. And even if he goes over the hill, can not be crashed. Normal if he go in that direction. So the trailer itself is now more stable, just the wheels. I didn't came to the wheels. You will see it when we are going to look at this session. Yeah, it's pretty okay. Yeah, that is crashing. So still, we get up, then we connect. So now he's doing again crazy things, you see. And that was not yesterday. Yesterday it was connecting correctly. This is what I mean. So I need to. Yeah, I did something to the camera, but yeah. But hold on, this is not. Why is he doing that now? Why is he doing that now? This one, it is a new one, it's not 100% okay, but look what I did. So, hold on, I'm gonna first ride it because there are some issues still we need to solve. So, now I have a horse with more animation. So, then you see, now you have this, you can make it smoother when you're turning, then also. But the other jumping, now I need to position it because it's really, for the moment you still need to do a correct positioning because we need to, that's why we have it connected. Hold on, let it do. So he flips, yeah, okay, so that's something the moment he connects. So maybe the points are or not correctly because I was trying to and this one also, you see, I put in the moment something is attached, it goes slower. Why I did it, if I do it on the other one it goes like, I added through and I changed it, that's maybe why it goes like 1500 or something. But then the wheels spin and then it seems like they're breaking apart in the sense of if you look at the wheel itself, it's nice and round, but the moment you go over speed, the wheels get like pins. But what I was testing yesterday, that is why it's still jaggling now. I need to have like here, look at, and now I stop. Now I'm gonna. Now the trailer. Hold on, I'm gonna have to check that we have a mouse pointer. So the problem was yesterday when I start the video, the arm, I removed everything. I removed the constraint from it. I put it back to so that it keeps its position because the moment I put physics on it, he start falling down, and when you connect, yeah, he's connected, but the arm is not, basically then I need to have, like, where the rider is sitting, the point downwards that keeps this up, something like it, okay? But what I did now, I'm gonna show you in a moment in the model itself, I had to add a center point around here, basically a cube, and then put the constraint on there that you have the rotation that normally the arm does, so the trailer is standing nice to the terrain. But like you see, it's same for the horse, eh? We have just a default horse, there's nothing done with foot placements and those things, but I think I'm gonna investigate that then, because in the end I want to have it that you can directly put it in the game, eh? Multiplayer, sorry guys, not for now, because to be honest, I cannot do that, and I don't think it will work in multiplayer. We can do a quick test, then we know. Hold on, that is not a big issue. We can try to see what is happening. Play from start. Hold on, where is the other window? There is the other window. Let's see what happens when we do what we have now in a dual session. Take that one, turn it a little bit Yep. Then take this one. Oh shit. No, we need to do it different. We need to do this one like that. No problem. You'll expand to your body. Wow. This one is what we need. So I'm going. Press M. What does it do? Nothing. Oh, first of all, nothing on the server side, and the client side. Whoa, it's way out of direction. Wait. Pretty strange. Okay, no problem. We are connected. What does the hitching of the trailer do? Nothing. That is totally doing nothing. So we don't have any response on the. Okay, I'm gonna get back off. And now it's failing to dismount. So that is totally not working. You see? Now I'm gonna possess the horse. No. Possession the horse also not working. Okay. So that will be a lot of work, I think, to get that done. But yeah, we will see. We will see how we can manage that in the end. It must work. It's no use to create a system like this, especially like now with the open world and those things. Okay, my game, I'm thinking to build gonna be a single player, but I'll have to start because, like I say, I don't know how to transfer things into multiplayer. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna so that you see that the other one is also. Working the depth, something around here. So it's really, yeah, pain in the butt to say to get it. And then, like you see now, that is headache. I'm thinking now, if I see it, then I already start thinking about from damn it. And then this one, yeah. Now he shoots over it. You see, now he shoots over it. I think I need to find a solution that he line trace directly to the object, or maybe use a sphere trace. Maybe that's maybe better. I will see. But hold on, let me quickly go into code. Here, this one doesn't matter. Okay, so that is our trailer. So what I did, first of all, I removed that that hitch constraint. Then, after a lot of tuning and searching and doing, then yesterday I start recording in the recording from yesterday. Instead of I rebuild it basically, so the hitch is still the hitch, and that's that that cube there, what we line trace to. Then I add a static mesh component, and I connected the cube to it. The cube is over there. Okay. The cube is over there. Back in position. That cube is connected to the steering block because if I connect it to the frame, then the wheels are not turning. I also gave this collision like only on the animal, so that when the animal is that's why I set it up like this. That's why I can even move this one a little bit closer. But if you go too close, and you try to connect, then the horse will be like something around here. So then there's all those little tweaking things we need to find, but maybe start thinking about the foot AK first, so that the horse stays in the correct position on the terrain, and then work further on the trail, and that stays in the correct position on the terrain. I will see. But so that then on the rest, yeah, that I did that. So the steering base, the suspension. I started with high numbers, you remember? I started with pretty high numbers in the beginning, but if you look back, the high numbers basically just here. But the high numbers basically disappeared. I came from 500,000 and I'm now at, hold on, where is it? PC arm in that one. I came to, it's connecting to the steering block, the scene one, that is that one. Like the other things we do in the in the grabbing on the constraint of the horse. I did also a lot of tweaking to get it done correctly. This is just again the swing two is free, the rest is blocked. It's nothing, and I didn't do nothing special for this. Okay, so but yeah, that is only to have the this part follow the terrain. Okay, so this is what we got now. I need to study further, but yeah. For now, I think we are getting what we want. I can maybe test something, yeah, with the multiplayer to do some replication on some things or anything, but yeah, we will see. Okay, so thanks for watching and I will see you next time. Bye bye.